Now that we've learned about the Ethernet packet, let's discuss the media used for Ethernet communication. As I mentioned, the first implementation of Ethernet had a bandwidth of 10 megabits per second and operated over coax cabling. This was standardized as 10 base 5. The 10 indicates the bandwidth, the base stands for baseband, and the 5 stands for 500 meters, which is the maximum distance the cable will support without a repeater. Later, 10 base 2 was added. This used a thinner coax cable, which made it easier to work with. And while the 2 and 10 base 2 stands for 200 meters, in reality, 10 base 2 only supports a maximum length of 185 meters. Later still, 10 base T was standardized. In this case, the T stands for twisted pair cabling. This type of cabling is limited to a maximum distance of 100 meters. Finally, fiber cabling was added with the 10 base FL standard. This allowed distances to reach into the kilometers. The first Ethernet networks were designed using only coax cable. Today, though, Ethernet can be supported on coax, twisted pair, or fiber cabling because switched-based networks support all these types of cables. In the following lessons, we'll learn about how the bandwidth levels supported by Ethernet continue to increase as the protocol evolves.